afternoon. So in the last 650,000 years, there have been seven cycles of glacial advance and retreat. When we brought in the last ice age, maybe about 7,000 years ago, marking the modern climatic era, and of course, human civilization. Most of these climatic changes have been the result of minor shifts in planetary orbit, solar radiation, and things like that. The current shift is measured by a largely different barometer, which is greenhouse gases. Now, in America, there are some questions and things, but regardless of a political ideology or scientific background, it's important that we invest in these meteorological, oceanographic, and climatology sciences. My name is Aaron. I'm an E major, and joining me today are the rest of my team, Zach and Alina, who are also both EEs, and Jimmy, who is a CE. And our project is the Sea Comet. You'll have to forgive this slide. It's actually an old one. They didn't put the updated one on there. The Sea Comet is a semi-autonomous research vessel designed to transit the world's ocean while directly collecting information and reporting it back to us. Now, we want to designate the difference between direct and indirect measurement, is that a direct measurement is ascertaining the exact quantity we want, and an indirect measurement, like the satellite, would be using other data to infer another piece of data. And we always found that direct measurement was much more accurate. So, using a 66-channel GPS chipset, a tilt-compensated compass, and a 9-degree of freedom IMU, our vessel will use its motor and rudder to guide itself along a series of GPS waypoints we give it. Along its path and at predetermined intervals, the sensors will collect air temperature, humidity, barometric pressure, it will collect water temperature and salinity, and it will also collect onboard diagnostics such as power consumption, battery pack, solar array status, and it will also do a self-health check. Using its onboard Iridium satellite modem, it will report this data back to us. We will also be able to communicate back with it to update GPS waypoints, switch it to dead reckoning versus automatic guidance, update the data collection frequency, and or change any other metrics we need to do. Our current progress is that we finalized our primary components list electrically, and we've actually constructed our motor and reduction drive setup for propulsion. Our mechanical design is finalized insofar as construction technique we want to use, but we're waiting to get our initial large batch of components in so that we can finalize the sizing. Because the bigger it has to be, of course, everything expands geometrically as far as materials we need. Our primary focus of the fall will be on hull construction, propeller design and selection, electrical connections, and the most daunting task for us will be coding. We only have one CE, and the rest of us are quite limited. We're currently well within our budgetary constraints, but time is going to be a continually pressing factor. It's kind of a grandiose project. If time permits, we'd like to develop the Sea Comet into a more complete weather station. For instance, we already have the sensors and tools on it to infer ocean conditions. We have accelerometers, so we should be able to measure wave cycle, peak height, and things like that. There are also additional inputs and outputs on the microcontroller that are going to be used for the one we selected. We would also like to develop a website to track its current progress on a map and communicate with it through a more complete interface versus a rudimentary one provided by Rockwalk, the people who make the satellite modem. I'd like to thank you all for your time, and at this point, open the floor to any questions you've got. The gentleman in the back.
I think it's a cool idea. I'm curious, is the primary purpose of this project to build the craft, or is it to collect the data? Because if you're going to collect the data, there's much cheaper,
yes,
simpler method than doing the...
A lot of it was we wanted to do something kind of grandiose, something that required a lot of building, multidisciplinary, and we wanted to get outside of our skill set and try to learn some new things along the way. Yes, sir?
So, clearly, if we have it out in the ocean, the Iridium is the right answer.
Yes, sir.
Did you consider, given that you're probably not going to take a trip to the ocean, go chunk it out 6 or 7 miles, did you consider using, say, a cellular modem instead to demonstrate the capability a little more effectively here, where you don't have to pay the crazy Iridium data rates?
Yes, yeah, you are right. The data, their costs are quite exorbitant, about $1 a text message, roughly. I told my team I would cover that out of my own budget. As far as the satellite modem goes, we didn't actually consider that. It's actually a pretty decent idea as far as testing goes. So we might, that'd be a great idea, actually. Yes, sir?
How large is that boat? I mean, if that's a standard size slide, that's a big boat.
It was an example picture we found because we're having, trying to trouble communicating. That one's like 22 feet long. Nothing we want to achieve. We're looking more like in the 8 to 10 foot kayak kind of range.
Did I understand you correctly? You don't want to build a boat?
Yeah.
A system and a navigation.
Yes.
And a bunch of sensors. I mean, yeah.
The sensors are off the shelf.
How much are you going to have?
One, I actually have experience. I've built a boat before. And I also built engines and stuff as a hobby, so does Zach.
Well, it's not a question of a question of
time. Oh, yeah. Time is a pressing issue. Yeah. That's why we've already started. You are absolutely correct.
You need to lose the boat. Go buy some.
The cost is the same.
They just get you a piece of plywood. I mean,
yes, sir?
You're supposed to present the design. I don't see the design.
This is not the slide. We were asked to make a correct one, a different one, and we sent it in, but apparently did not make it up there.
Does that have a log diagram?
Yeah.
Do you have a poster to show that?
Yes, the poster does have a log diagram as well.
Question. Is that preliminary analysis on power requirements?
Yeah, some. We know what our motor can use maximum. We haven't found out what its most efficient point is. We know what all the sensors absorb.
So is your onboard battery the only source of power?
No, we have a 320 watt panel, and the battery pack budget is 1.1 kilowatt hours.
And that's including the weight of the motor and the craft?
Yeah. It's only ideal speed is like 2 knots, 3 miles an hour.
And you accounted for all the big waves and the high seas?
Yeah, I've actually jet skied across the open ocean several times, 80 to 100 miles. So I've had a lot of experience.
But unfortunately, in this case, you're not sitting on the boat to maneuver the boat if something happens.
No. Unfortunately, yeah, that is the factor.
All right, any more questions? Then we can take the two.
Thank you.